Hey guys, it's Nate, aka The Foot Accountant. Welcome back to the channel. It is Friday and it's Premier League Team of the Season Friday inside of FIFA 21. Week 2 of Team of the Season is bringing a very new twist to things because usually right now we don't know what team is going to be coming in packs, maybe except for some leaks. But today we know the exact squad coming today for Premier League Team of the Season because EA has already tweeted it out. We know the objectives that we're getting, not really the SBCs, but we know the objectives, the entire 15 cards that will be in packs, and also possibly a potential leaked SBC flashback Gareth Bale. We'll talk about that as well. There was a lot that happened yesterday. This all went down right around the content drop yesterday, but the market movements are still happening into this morning. So I want to talk about the content we're getting today with this team of the season right here, the Bundesliga team of the season vote that is also live, and the leaks, the objectives, and what's going to happen on the market today. Because does this change anything for the market? And that answer is yes, because we've already seen that change happen a little bit. Now let's take a look at this team, right? We were all surprised when EA tweeted this out yesterday. Now supposedly there's going to be a social media blackout. I don't know too much about it, but I've heard that there's going to be some sort of social media blackout in combating racism, I believe, is the goal of that blackout. And that is taking place with some of the big clubs in Europe. I think it's actually, you know, happening all weekend, I believe. So I think that's why EA tweeted it out today. And you saw some tweets from Manchester City and Leeds United as well. So I'm not sure if we're going to hear or see any tweets from EA Sports today, if they're taking part of that and if they're respecting that decision from the EFL clubs or whatever. But I think that's why they released it today. Now we got the full team tweeted out. These are the players with the stats. I don't know if these guys have in-game stats. They do not. These cards do not have in-game stats yet. I believe the in-game stats might be on FootWiz because FootWiz is partnered up with EA Sports. FootBin is not. But a lot of these cards, people were left desiring more. You've got a Bruno Fernandes card that has -4 pace and -2 or -3 physical, I think, from his team of the year item. He does have +2 pace. You've got a De Bruyne card that has more physical, more defense, but I think less pace, less shot, less passing than his team of the year card. And then you have other cards like a Luke Shaw, who only got +2, +3 in some stat categories. And Cancelo as a 91 rated card. A lot of people were feeling like this should be a 93 or a 94. So overall, people are not very pleased with a lot of these cards because they feel like the boosts should be bigger. Gundogan has like 82 stamina. It's only a +4. The Mount card looks pretty decent. Ruben Dias got a pretty nice boost. But overall, I think a lot of people are just, you know, not super pleased with how these cards look right now in this game. Now, we'll get to talking about that and how that affected the market. But we do know these are the players. So that is one thing, of course, that is different than usual. Usually, we don't know the players heading into a promo. So these are the exact cards we will see today. Now, also, we're going to be seeing this Rodri objective. I know my cam is covering it a little bit. That's going to be an objective CDM that everybody's going to be able to attain. I feel like some people might play as a center back as well, lacking on the pace a bit, but really good defensive stats. That'll be an interesting objective. And then also we're going to have this Bamford objective player. Now, I don't know if both of these are going to drop at the same time, but my guess is that they are. We got 2 objective squads last week. And also, we might not be seeing a secondary TOTS team in packs. Now, we have the Saudi League that is probably coming, but that might not be dropping today. There might only be Prem TOTS cards in packs today on Friday. So we'll talk about that a little bit as well. But again, this is the team put in on FootBin. These are the exact cards with the exact stats that we will see today on the market. And I do think that with all the saved up packs, these guys are going to kind of act like last week with community TOTS. They're going to get cheap early, then they're going to rebound later into the nighttime. So we'll continue to talk about that. A couple other things to keep in mind. There was some pack code added yesterday for an 80 plus rated rare player and a new icon pack, a prime or moments icon midfielder, which this pack has to be cheap because there's a lot of prime and icon moments midfielders, cam, center mids, right mid, left mid, that are like 200,000 to 300,000 coins. So hopefully that SBC is pretty cheap. Now we also had the guaranteed Saudi League team of the season pack as well. Now back to what I mentioned about possibly not being 2 different sets of teams and packs today. This is the message that you got when you went into FIFA later tonight or earlier tonight about red foot champions rewards for the Premier League. And this is reworded from what it was last week. It says, TOTS Week and League rewards that guarantee team of the season special items will correspond to the TOTS squad in packs at the time the rewards are issued. See the breakdown for the next couple of weeks. So it's a different breakdown because I think it mentions here the Friday Friday's TOTS pack release. So it might be one of those things where we see the Premier League TOTS today on Friday, but we don't actually see the secondary league, which we're expecting to be the Saudi league. We might not actually see that until Sunday or until Monday in packs, and they might have those overlap a little bit. So I just want to kind of put that out there that technically the chance of you packing a TOTS card today, if you go and actually look inside of the store, the percentages might be a lot less today, purely because that there's not going to be a second team in packs. Now, that could be incorrect, but right now we have the EFL and the community TOTS in packs, and it's 18%, right? So we will see if that changes at all today. Now, I've got some packs saved up. I'm almost finished with my 83 times 25, but I wanted to make that point. And I still think everybody's going to open their packs today because they've been saving for Prem TOTS, so why would they not open them? Some people might save for a later team in the season, but I doubt that there's going to be a lot of hype for saving for a later TOTS that you might think is better. Just because you thought this one was not as good. It's probably this one right here, this TOTS squad with only 15 players. This is probably setting the norm for the next couple weeks of team of the season, with maybe some less than desired lackluster upgrades. Seems to be probably what is going to be coming. Now, of course, Bundesliga is basically confirmed to be next because this vote is happening right now. The Bundesliga vote, and some people are not happy with the options of cards in here. If you look at the defenders, Davies, Hummels, Guerrero, Brooks, Angelino. It's just kind of interesting, right? And then you get into the midfielders and you see guys like Nkunku and Alaba. Nkunku already has a TOTS card, but Leon Bailey in the attackers vote as well. So not really sure what's going on. If Leon Bailey or Nkunku would happen to win the Bundesliga TOTS vote, would they actually have their same card re-released back into packs? That's probably what it would be. But this vote is live until mid next week. I think it's like May 6th. You can vote on Bundesliga team of the season. So that is the other thing that did happen yesterday. Now, when this was tweeted out yesterday, when EA tweeted this out, the market kind of went into a frenzy because they saw this Bruno Fernandes. And I think a lot of people were expecting to see a Bruno Fernandes card similar to this KDB from last year. And if you look at these stats from last year in FIFA 20, you look at these cards and you're saying, man, the individual stats and the overall rating of these cards, there are 11 players in this team that are above 94 rating. 11 players. You look at this TOTS squad this year, you only have four. You only have four cards that are above 94 rated. De Bruyne, Bruno, Salah, and Kane. So you go from 11 over 84s last year to four this year. And that is the basis of why people are not very happy today. So people saw that Bruno Fernandes' card was basically worse than his team of the year. This card was like 2.2 million coins. He rebounded almost up to 3 mil. He went from 2.3 all the way to 3 mil. Came back down and is now rebounded back up a little bit. Now, again, the new Bruno that's going to come out has 92 pace and less physical and less defense. Minus one physical and minus four defense, minus one dribble, minus one passing the same shot, and then, of course, that plus two pace. So it's going to be interesting to see how these TOTS cards continue to affect the other team of the years and stuff like that on the market. But I will say this, a lot of these team of the year cards, again, are rare. And, you know, team of the season cards are going to be supplied. They're going to be packed a lot today. And I'm really curious to see how much that Bruno comes onto the market, because that's going to really dictate what happens to this card. Like for De Bruyne's team of the season card with the similar stats, but not quite the same. This one has more pace, plus one, better shooting, better passing. But the team of the season card has the 80 defense and the 90 physical. So it kind of depends. You know, KDB's TOTS card looks a lot more like a box-to-box center mid or even a DM. But then KDB's team of the year card looks more like a box-to-box or a cam, I guess you could say. So very interesting when you look at the stat differences. But a lot of people bought up cards today. You look at a lot of icons that are on the market as well. A lot of these cards have exploded upwards in price a lot because people saw what we had in the game today and they saw these cards that were coming out and they said, man, I'm just going to go buy the card that I want for my team because these TOTS cards are not good. Eto, 3.4 million coins, that is up. If you take a look across the game too, I think like Mid Hullet, who is a very popular card that a lot of people want to go out and buy, 3.3 million coins. This guy was like 3.1 to 3.2. So a lot of these cards did inch upwards because people just went out and bought stuff, right? People just went out. And some of the cards from community team this season as well, people saw the lackluster stats on Cancelo, and this Wan-Bissaka card has absolutely flown. 630,000 coins. He is up 100K from where he was in packs earlier this week, even during rewards yesterday on Thursday. So Mukiele went up a lot. A lot of the community team this season exploded yesterday because people wanted to buy those cards. And to be completely honest, that Wan-Bissaka right back card and cards that are inside of community TOTS look better than the cards that are in Premier League team this season, which is criminal in my opinion. I really don't understand why EA did not give the business and do the juice on these cards. It doesn't make sense to me, but hopefully that just means that we have a huge summer upcoming and they're trying to prolong the game cycle with even more higher rated cards, 98s, 99s. I'm not entirely sure what's going to go on with that. But again, let's talk about the market. One thing before we do that, this is getting into the leak territory. So this is not actually a leak. It was actually in the game. I saw this myself live on our stream yesterday. We looked into the concepts. There was a 90 rated Gareth Bale. So in my opinion, I don't know if this is going to drop today because I would assume they would drop a TOTS player SBC today. But soon we will be seeing a 90 rated Gareth Bale flashback SBC card because it was added into concepts. So that means we should be seeing, and I think some week or sometime this week during Premier League TOTS is the perfect time to release this SBC. So just kind of keep that on the horizon. That is an SBC we should see soon. We didn't have it yesterday. I doubt it would come today. Maybe, who knows? But probably later on this week is a definite Bale SBC probably coming out into this game. So what's going on with the market other than that? Again, like this, a tall card today. We had a Boulaya SBC that was very overlooked. This center attacking mid 5-star skills forced a weak foot Boulaya card. 160K, right? Kind of an interesting card. And of course, that is a nice green link to Atal. So Atal is banging right now. You know, Adama was up at 760 at one point today. I do think you will still see prices drop off on the market today because what's going to happen is these team of the seasons, even though they are not very they're not very delectable, I guess you could say, that they don't look as good as we think they should with as high of the stat boost. What that's going to do is, and especially with the lower overall ratings, they're going to get supplied more on the market. They're going to be cheaper than we expect, and that's probably going to make people sell cards just to go buy and try out the new ones, right? Because some people are not even mad about TOTS. They're like, hey, these cards look sick. They're awesome, which to be fair, these are some of the best cards we have in the game. We just thought they were going to be better. That's why we're a little upset. But these cards are going to be the talk of the town again today. So you're going to see a lot of pack supply right away, as we saw with the community TOTS in the first hour or two, then probably a quick rise up. A ton of coins are going to enter the market once again today. So if you're looking for things to sink your coins into, I would say watch the panic selling in the morning. I've already seen some low prices kind of fly under the radar. I got one Mane tonight, 820,000 coins. Now that was on an open bid. That was a little bit lucky, I'll be completely honest. But some of these cards have gotten, you know, not cheap, but they have dropped down in price tonight. This Aubameyang, of course, with the Arsenal loss is down, but some other cards are very high. This Real Ferdinand was in the 800s. He's 930 right now. I would 100% be watching your icons today for sure, because if people are not interested in these brand new TOTS cards that are coming out, what they're going to go do is they're going to go buy other special cards in this game that they're super duper excited about and they want to try out. Now, I bought a Harry Kane today at 470,000 coins. How much is this guy right now? He is back down to 469. This guy's pretty low, man, and this card has more pace than the Harry Kane that is being released as a team of the season card. Also, Harry Kane is 92 dribbling on his new TOTS card, but the agility balance is basically the same on that TOTS card than it is on this Rule Breaker. So it's going to be very interesting to watch the market today. Now, I will say this. If you're looking to invest in cards today, be careful if you're looking for Premier League specials like out-of-packs cards that we've talked about. I do think those will do very well today, but be careful with center defensive mids and strikers, because whenever we have an objective player or an SBC, that can kill the rise a little bit, because of course maybe people can't do the objective right away, but if there's some SBC player, like let's say Bale drops today, I would expect future star Saka as a right mid in the Prem to be a card that might drop off a little bit. So just watch out for the strikers and CDMs, because of these two objectives, if they do come out, they might not rise as well later on tonight. But defenders, midfielders, maybe that Vardy card, I'm very interested to see what this Vardy card, does today, right? Because this Vardy's team of the season is 94 rated, a +2 upgrade, that's it. 95 pace, 93 shooting, and this Vardy does not have skill move or weak foot upgrades as far as we know. And this Vardy's got the 4-star skills and the 5-star weak foot. So people are honestly probably going to value this Vardy card, the foot birthday. At some point, it might kind of be like a foot birthday Mbappe situation last year, where this one might be more expensive than the team of the season. Because the stats aren't that far off, and he's got that 5-star weak foot and 4-star skills, which is very, very valued in this game. So that's going to be a very interesting thing to watch today. But you are going to see a lot of the market, if it's meta cards in general, really, really pick up tonight. So watch out for lowering prices. I do think you're still going to see panic selling. I do think you will, because a lot of people are going to say, hey, we can see these cards now. And, you know, some casuals are not going to see the team right away. They're going to wait till they see it in game. And they're going to say, wow, these are cards that I want to actually get. So you might see more selling post content on today, on Friday, because you'll see people that say, oh my goodness, these cards are cheap, they're coming out in the game. So you might see more panic selling in that first hour. And then, of course, as people open up all their saved up packs, then you will see a lot of stuff really pick back up on the market and stuff like that. And also, if the SBC player coming out, whoever that is too, that could impact the market as well. So I do think you will see a little bit of panic selling this morning. It's going to be very interesting to watch these TOTS cards when they first come on the market. Again, with that pack supply in the first 30 minutes to an hour, I'm very, very, very interested in some of these cards. Like, I'm going to be watching Salah for sure. Definitely watching these out of pack. Watch your out of pack items for players like Salah, who's getting a team of the season today. I'm going to see if this goes on a bid at 868, because this guy was, I sold one of these at 990K literally 24 hours ago. So he's down a decent amount. I think Salah, while his card, the new one that's coming out, is only 96 rated, this one's a 94. I still think this one is kind of an interesting play. Now, of course, I don't believe they're doing any skill move or weak foot upgrades, because we didn't see any of those on Foot Wiz, but we will have to kind of look out and watch for some of those. So again, the stuff that we talked about with the market in terms of the Premier League specials and the market going very high late tonight, I don't think that changes. I do think the market goes very high tonight on Friday night with all of the coins and all of the packs that are open. But you see this right here, right? You see this Mane getting listed up on an open bid. Let me see what these guys bought these cards for. That Salah was bought for 951. This Mane was bought at a mil. This Mane was bought at 160. What a crazy snipe that was. Goodness me. And then this one was bought at 860. So, you know, you have people from all ranges of buy times on these cards. I was watching an Ansu Fati Future Stars that was bought at 2 million coins today. So there's still people in this game that are selling cards in preparation for Team of the Season that have held on to cards for a long time. So I think a sign of, you know, panic and people getting their coins out before Team of the Season is an open bid like this. So you're going to see some open bids tomorrow. You're going to see some undercuts. Sorry, not tomorrow, today on Friday. And all I would say is I really expect that market rise to happen tonight unless something crazy, crazy happens today on Friday. But again, it just seems that this Team of the Season looks a little bit underwhelming. Now, I'm sure these cards are going to be great in game, and a lot of people are going to want to go after them, but that Cancelo card is going to be pretty hyped. You know, of course, since these cards aren't too far off their road to the finals, like especially Salah and Cancelo. Cancelo's road to the final right now is 300,000 coins. I expect this card to drop this morning, because I think this 91 Cancelo that comes out today might be 400,000 coins. Like, it might be 400 to 450K plus two pace. I mean, he got a huge shooting boost, decent passing boost, but you know, the stats that matter for a right back, he got plus three dribbling, plus two defense, and plus two physical. That's not a huge upgrade, right? So I'm still kind of curious to see how that is impacted with the market today. But I think some of these cards that have other specials that are somewhat close to their rating, the TOTS cards are going to get so supplied today. It's going to be interesting to see what happens with those in price. But there's also going to be a lot of demand, right? It's always a lot of demand for these new cards. So that is something we have to kind of keep in mind with and watch out for. Again, I'm going to be focusing on icons a lot today. I really think I am. Icons, Premier League specials that get sold off, and just cards that I think people are going to be buying later tonight. Now, if you want to buy cards for your team, I mean, if I'm being completely honest, I think a lot of this stuff is really high. People buy their cards, but then you know what? We get upgrade packs coming out later this week. We're going to get more SBCs like that Bale, whenever that will come out. More TOTS player SBCs will probably come out from Prem Team of the Season as well. they seem to be doing a lot of SBCs right now because they're not doing the actual players in packs. So they put 15 players out in packs. Then they do like three or four SBCs throughout the week. So that's kind of interesting. But seriously, I'm going to be watching Icons today. This Vieira is up a lot. 2 mil for him. He's definitely back up in price. Some of your team of the years today absolutely exploded. Like Cristiano Ronaldo team of the year was up at 7 million coins, which is a price that this guy was before the market crash heading into team of the season. He's still 6.7 now. So I think some of the stuff is up a lot and it will drop off next week. So just be careful if you're buying any of these cards for your team, because I think the TOTS cards that are going to come out today are going to be cheaper than normal, just with the supply, of course, and just with the fact that a lot of people are not super duper hyped for these cards because they think the ratings aren't that good. But of course, it still is a hype Friday, right? It still is a hype day. I hope you guys pack something sick. If you guys saved up packs or whatever it may be, good luck if you're ripping those. And yeah, that's the video for today, boys. I hope this helped you out. If it did, smash a thumbs up on it. Comment down below if you have any questions. And subscribe if you are new. It's been Nate the Foot Accountant, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace out.